All right, world, what's up? It's your boy, Ju Morrissey, rap coach, extraordinaire, leader of the legends, mentor to the motivated. Today, we're going to break down Belly, No Option, a classic track from about 3 years ago from what, for me, is one of the most underrated rappers in the game. No, I'm not Canadian. No, I did not know about his earlier records. I haven't even heard, honestly, his records before this one. But I know dude is a beast. I know he's gotten the biggest cosigns, Hov, Joe Budden. Anybody who's listening to this cat knows he is the dog. And I had the fortunate pleasure of kind of falling up on this record a few years ago, and I've been a fan ever since. Part of the reason I like this, oh, he's signed to The Weeknd as well, another big cosign. Part of the reason I like this record is, as it is with a lot of these out of rap recent song structure breakdowns and all that, it's about the song structure. I really am a big fan of rappers that find ways to not just do the normal verse, chorus section. And I'm always hammering home to y'all, like, this is what I'm messing with. This is what I'm into when I listen to a rapper. Can this person construct a real song, an anthem, something that I want to sing along with multiple parts rather than just, yo, I'd be spitting these bars, hot fire, and then into the chorus. So for me, this is a very good example, again, of active songwriting with multiple sections, melodies, bars. It's got pretty much everything I'm looking for as a rap fan. So I want to break this down. Sort of like the YG Suru breakdown the other day. I'm like, I'm not even doing this for the views or whatever. I don't know. This is an older song. You know, it's not trending or whatever you want to say, but I'm messing with it. So I wanted to be sure for letting the record state for the history books. I'm messing with Belly. This is tight stuff, and I think it's great songwriting. Hopefully you'll find it helpful. Let's rock into this joint.
Yeah. Not for days, nigga. It's the ones you keep close to hurt you the most. I'm drinking on my own, doing personal toast. Probably fucked your bitch and you ain't even know.
No.
I should probably wash my dick with detergent and soap.
Yeah.
Round the city with my vision blur.
All right, so first thing is, this is a very well-mixed song. Even by just professional music standards, I think the vocal is just sitting right there on top of the beat, real nice. They've added a little bit of distortion to his voice. Belly does that a lot, as I learned later after studying him through the tracks. He comes in smooth, easy. One thing I like about Belly is he gives me that Biggie feel, but with a new edge. He doesn't make me feel like I'm listening to a Biggie rewrite as some other artists who are influenced by him has. He's coming in with bars, with clever little metaphors. He's really good at making these compact punchlines or these compact double entendres. And so we're just kind of riding in. The beat's going to drop, and he's going to keep the same vocal tone, which, you know, often we tell y'all, like, you know, you want to maybe switch up your vocal tone when the beat does something different, but in this case, it works really well, and he's getting in his mode right now.
Back to back Benz's, nigga, his and hers. $1 million pussy, you should get insured. I hit the town and watch the city burn. Had the keys, had the city lock.
Maybe just a little bit in change of vocal, and getting a little bit of that grunt in there.
Hit the pussy, do the diddy bop.
Yeah.
Before the beer was all ZZ Top, when me and Sal was eating dinner off a TV box. Find the cancer, then you cut them off. See, my daddy was a dealer, and my mama said it's rubbing off.
All right, so this is going to come back again, this section. Daddy was a dealer, that's a Lil Wayne line. You know, found the cancer, then you cut them off. See, my daddy was a dealer, right? This is a pre-chorus. Pre-chorus, so we're already getting into the song structure, unorthodox. I think he's rocked out about 8 bars. Same vocal tone, a little bit of grunts, using his ad-libs well there, you know, all that kind of fun stuff. And we're introduced to our first real section that will come back repeated in this pre-chorus.
Somebody tell me what a tunnel costs, because I've been burning bridges, give a fuck how I come across.
Bang.
Say I love you, that's the drugs talking. Heard him hate.
So we've got the give a fuck how I come across ad-lib with the scratches, sort of the throwback scratches as the ad-lib. Another trick. I'm often looking for this myself, or I get my producer or engineer to mess with that. Is there a last line or a particularly good line that's kind of catchy in my rap that we can continue on into the chorus? Can it bleed into the chorus to give it that nice transition? So if you're hearing in the background, I give a fuck how I come across. It's the last line of the verse, and it's used as an ad-lib again to kind of bring that continuity between the verse and the chorus.
Bang. Tunnel cars, cause I've been burning bridges, give a fuck how I come across.
Bang. How I come across, you hear that? How I come across. Right, so you hear that, you have a fuck how I come across. So you're using that ad lib as essentially part of the chorus. We have a melodic chorus, four bars. Nice little melody, doesn't do too much with it. Lets that the effect does its work. Nice open chorus, nice simple melody, easy to understand concept. All the sort of checklist of a chorus. Not too many words, repeated phrases, introducing a new sound, right? We got the melody where we haven't heard. Now we're going to go into the post-chorus, or you could call it chorus 1B, second section, depending on how you define it. Talked a lot about that in the YG analysis of Suwoo. And we're going to slide into that.
Who left the drugs on the table? Who left these hoes in my house? Who left this dope in my couch? Hold on, you open your mouth.
All right. Again, watch the Drake nonstop tutorial we did. Talked about the call and response as a classic hip-hop tactic, but with a new, so you're using your ad lib as the response. Who left these drugs on the table? Who left these drugs in my house? You? In Drake's case, it's came and went, give me that shit. Same tactic. This is 3 years before that. I'm sure as we continue to review many other songs, we're going to hear this again and again and again. But this is a tactic that can be used. You know, I'm taxing that tactic. Taxing that tactic. Tax that tactic, right? I'm taxing that tactic because I know it's easier to write because all I got to do is write half a bar and then just repeat what I said or fill it in. That's the fun part. That's the sort of cheat code from a how to rap perspective. But it's also just catchier. It's just straight up catchier, you know, rather than a full length bar, especially in the case of something like this where it's a post-chorus or bridge, whatever you want to call it. It just works really well. So be sure to check out that Drake nonstop tutorial where we talk a little bit more about that call and response in the verse as a tactic.
Changed up, had the curve from pitching the weight.
Now we have the vocal tone changing for the first time. He's raising his voice for the first time, right? Verse 2. We're always talking about spicing up verse 2. I see a lot of beginning artists, they're like, yo, I call it the verse 2 blues. You know, I write a dope first verse, got me a good chorus, and I get to verse 2, and I'm like, I don't know what to do next. And I get that, because I get that as a writer myself all the time. You know, I kill it on verse 1, finally got me to chorus, and then there's a part of my brain is telling me, yo, like, damn, I got to write an entire other one. It has to be as good as the first one? Like, this is too much pressure, man. You know what I mean? So what I usually do is find tactics such as this in order to make verse 2 exciting. That could be switching of the flow. As Drake did on Nonstop. Eminem does it on verse 3 of Kill You, as we talked about. You can also do it in simply a vocal tone change. Raise your voice when you were quiet. Quiet your voice when you were loud for verse 1. Right? So this is what we're seeing Belly doing, and it works perfectly, especially because he's used the bridge, who let the drug in the table, as the transition into the change in voice. It wasn't just straight out of the chorus.
Either way, I'm about to ball like I'm missing the plate. Boy, you never touch base, I'm calling you out. Though we never seen you out, you was playing a safe. Call me Judas Priest, now she got some new beliefs. Photo shooting like a week, she won't even need.
Yeah, I mean, dude, he's just verse 2, he's like, let it loose. And it's worked so well because of the multiple sections of the track have led us up to this crescendo in verse 2. I was given 4 bars of an intro with the chill voice. Then he had 4 more bars to finish off verse 1 with the chill voice. Then we get this nice, we get a pre-chorus. Then we get this nice melodic chorus. Then we get a bridge, a catchy call and response bridge. Now I'm allowed to raise my voice and tell y'all I really get down. I really get busy. You know, that's how I see the tactics that Belly is using, and it's just fantastic.
Dreams are winning, got me losing sleep. Versace sheets just to watch Medusa sleep. Ayy, up for days, I've been up for days. Mixing up the love and hate, that's a double day. Dope wave, that's my lane, call me Mr. Vane. Renegade, mixing up the batch with the lemonade. Cut
them off. Pre-chorus.
See, my daddy was a dealer and my mama said it's rubbing off. Somebody tell me what a tunnel cost. Cause I've been burning bridges, give a fuck how I come across.
Chorus.
Say I love you, that's the drugs talking. Heard I'm hating, that's the...
Remember, still hear that? Give a fuck how I come across. That's a tactic, yo. Got to use it if we need to. That's how do we fill out this chorus. Got that nice little... You know, catchy, give a fuck how I come across. Cut that up, get the engineer, producer to do what he need to do. Nice transition.
To love talking, and the God y'all left me no option. Swear to God y'all left me no option. Who left the drugs on the table? Who left these hoes?
Post chorus again.
Hoes in my house. Who left this dope in my couch? Hold on, you open your mouth. Oh.
There it goes again. And we're out. We're good. And then you just let it ride out because it's 2015. I mean, it's 2015, 2018. New generation, we don't need more than two verses, especially when you have these really effective other sections, pre-choruses, post-chorus, to fill out the track. Right? So what are we hearing? We've heard in this track, we've heard probably a total of 20 bars of just verse rap. Right? We got the intro. I believe it's 8 bars, maybe 12. I haven't counted, but let's just say 12 for the sake of argument. And we got 12 bars of verse rap. You know, bringing us up to 24. Now, classic rap structure. If we're going to the 90s, it's 3 verses of 16, not repeated, right? That's terrible at math. Whatever, that's like 48 or something. Y'all can roast me in the comments. That's a lot of verse rap. And as I've talked about, and we talk about this channel, in the new energy, the new generation, we're not doing as much as verse rap. Y'all, here's another bar. And then now we're at the 12th bar. Because I want to rap some more, I'm going to just rap some more. Now we're at the 16th bar. Now I can do this chorus. I'm not going to have a pre-chorus. I'm not going to have a post-chorus. I'm not going to do nothing original. I'm going to just rap some more. Right? Now, there's two sides to that. It's fun to rap once you've rapped for a long time. Right? There's a lot of cats. A lot of people watch this because they're up and coming or they're trying to get over that intermediate hump. And we all get there, no matter how good or bad any of us are. But a lot of people are struggling to get to the point that it's fun all the time, right? Because you got writer's block. You got to doubt yourself. You're always trying to, you know, you get your verse 2 blues we talked about. That happens. But at a certain point, it becomes fun and it becomes addictive to write. You can't fall. Once you get to that point, you can't fall into that trap of, I should just rap more because I like rapping. I mean, the song is what's deciding. The beat, the structure, what's going to be catchy, what's going to be memorable decides how much I get to rap on this particular track. If I want to rap all day and just bar, 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 I can prepare my sway in the morning, 5 fingers of death all day. I can get my fire in the booth moment. You know, all the stuff Drake's been doing on the side recently. This is in July 2018, so right after Scorpion, you know what I mean? Y'all remember, right? I could do that all day. But as long as I'm doing a song that I intend for your average non-rap listener, rap bars all day listener, chicks, cats that just, you know, investors and millionaires who just like to listen to rap, ballers, gangsters, all the people that are just listening to the song because they think it's a good song, not because they want to hear you flip 80,000 million bars like it was 98. And that's no disrespect to that era because I love it. I wouldn't be a rapper without it. And I'm often re-listening to just old classic Cassidy and you know, Funk Flex freestyles. I love all that stuff. Loaded Lux, all that energy I love, man. But right now we're talking about song structure, and this channel is kind of more on a song structure tip because I think that is what's stopping a lot of artists from getting to where they need to go. You know, a lot of y'all watching, especially the more experienced folks, it's not really that you don't know how to rap. I've coached a lot of people that know how to rap, right? I can spit. You know what I mean? People can get to that point. It's that, are we making an experience, an environment, as I like to say, a song is an environment, a song is a room, etc. Are we making an environment for our listeners, for our fans? And that's my goal. Not saying I do it perfectly every time, but that's my goal. And hopefully that's your goal as well. So with this in mind, we're listening to a track where here's a rapper that can spit bars all day. And anybody who knows saw the LA Leakers freestyle with Belly. Everybody's seen Belly on Funk Flex. He can do that. But he knows what we all need to know, which is the song comes first, right? And in this case, all he needed was an 8-bar first verse with a, and then get in that pre-chorus, get in that chorus. Let's worry about all that other stuff later. Let's worry about showing them how lyrically amazing I am. You know what I mean? Let's worry about that later. All right, so we have this structure, roughly 12 bars of verse rap. We have a pre-chorus that's repeated twice. We have a post-chorus that I believe is repeated 3 times. And we have a chorus that is melodic, simple, easy to go, easy to sing, nice simple effects, blah. And it's great. Beats tight. Tight video, by the way. And here we are. Similar to the nonstop breakdown. Let's not overthink these. I'm talking to myself now. I'm talking to Drew. Don't overthink the rap, bro. Make the song. Make an environment. Hashtag make an environment. Make the song an environment. This is a great example of that. Belly is fantastic. Super big supporter. I'm trying to see him. Man, I was just in Europe on tour myself, and Belly was out there on tour, and I wasn't able to catch the same city. But I'm definitely trying to see him live. I haven't seen him live yet. Dude is a beast. Super underrated. Yeah, that's Belly No Option for you. Might do some more Belly breakdowns. We did another breakdown of the LA Leakers freestyle. You can check that out. Be sure to follow me on Twitter at HowToRapDrew. Also on Instagram at HowToRapDrew. I'm super active on those two platforms at this point. If you like this content, you want more, be sure to let me know what songs you want to hear about. Leave a comment. If you disagree with anything, let us know. You know, if you agree with something, let us know. Feel free to give your own analysis as well in the comments. Be sure to smash up those likes. Need to see them thumbs up. And subscribe if you've never seen us before. We do this stuff. This is fun. Thanks for watching. It's the Big Homie Drew. Shout out to Belly. Give a fuck how I come across.